So hopefully you just finished watching the video on LearnZillion all about line plots. So I just want to do a quick review and remind you that when you create a line plot, it's a type of a graph that's used to show how often something happens or the quantity of something. Quantity is how many of something. So you may make a line plot to show the number of books that people read in January, or the number of home runs hit by each player in a baseball season, how many hours people exercised each week. And in this particular example, we are seeing a line plot about the number of children in each family, from a third grade classroom. So if we were back at school and we were all in the class together, we could create a line plot of the number of children in each of our families, just like this group of students did. So in a line plot, remember there's only one axis. There's not an x and a y axis. It's just a number line. And the smallest number represents like the least number of whatever that line plot is. So in this case, there are clearly everybody in the third grade classroom has at least one child in their family because obviously they're there. If zero was the fewest number in that situation, there would be a zero on this line plot. And then in this particular scenario, there are no more than five children in any of the families of this third grade classroom. So we can obviously easily see that none of the families have six or more kids, because if they did, then those numbers would be here on the number line. So some families only have one child, some have two children, some have three children, some have four, and some have five children. The X's tell you how many kids that applies to. So for example, there are three kids in the class that only have one child in their family. Okay? There are two kids in the class that have two children in their family. There are four kids in the class that have three children in their family. There is one child in the class that has four children in their family. And there are two children in the class that have five children in the family. Okay, so I'd like you to get out your blank piece of paper and a pencil and number your paper 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So 7 through 13. And we're going to answer these questions together. I may pause and have you try some of them on your own, and then we'll check them. So let's look at number 7. What does each X on the line plot stand for? Each X on the line plot stands for a family or a student in the class. So I'm going to write each X on the line plot stands for one family. Okay. What do the numbers on the number line stand for? So each of these numbers. Okay. Each of these numbers stands for the number of children in each family. So number of children in each family, right? Some families have one child, some have two, three, four, or five children. How many families have two children? I want you to see if you can just try that one out. Write down an answer that you think is correct, and then we'll talk about it. Let's look at it. The number two, okay, this is the number of children in the family. So if we want to see how many families have two children, we have to see how many X's go with the number two. And that's two X's. So two families have two children. Okay. How many families have fewer than 4 children? Fewer would mean less. See if you can figure out how many families have fewer than 4 children and write down an answer. Okay, so let's talk about it. Fewer than 4 children means 3 children, or 2 children, or 1 child. All of these are less than 4. So the number of families that have less than 4 children would be all of these families. All of these families have less than 4 children in them. So we can count them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So 9 families have fewer than 4 children. Number 11. What is the greatest number of children in the families surveyed? The greatest number of children in the families surveyed. Let's see if you can figure that out. Remember, this number line shows you the number of children in each family. No families have more than 5 children, because if they did, there would be a spot for them on this number line, and there would be some families that had 6 children or 7 or 8, and they don't. So the greatest number of children in the family surveyed is 5. Number 12. How many families took part in the survey? So they want to know how many total families were surveyed. See if you can figure it out. Okay. In order to figure out how many total families were surveyed, you need to count the X's, because each X represents one family. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 total families took part in the survey. Did all of the families surveyed have children? Answer yes or no. Did all of the families surveyed have children? Yes or no? This one seems a bit obvious. If the children themselves were carrying out the survey to figure out how many kids were in each of their families, they obviously are one of the kids in their families. So all of the families had to have at least one child. And as you can see, there are no families that had 0 children. If there were, you would see a 0 here, and you would see some families that didn't have any children. So yes, all of the families surveyed had some children, or at least one. I want to make sure you understand. If I were to extend this, and I were to be able to have a 0 here, and I were to survey some families in my neighborhood, some of those families might not have kids. You could have some X's here above the 0, which would mean that some families don't have any kids. They might just have a husband and wife, or something like that. So I just want you to understand that that would be possible. Okay. Now, I am going to share this worksheet, this line plot worksheet, with you on your assignments page, and you're going to work through it. So you're going to work through the problems on a blank piece of paper, and then you're going to transfer your answers to the Google form like we often do. But I'm going to give you a few hints to help you get started as you go, before you go. So Tom carried out a survey to find out how many raisins there are in boxes of different brands. He made a line plot to show the results of his survey. So I didn't know that there were very many brands of raisins. I don't think very many companies made raisins, but hey, I guess there's different brands of raisins. So, this person wanted to see, like, how many raisins are inside each of the boxes. So, do different brands have a different number of raisins in the boxes? So, we have raisins per box. So, we have 25 through 31. So, that tells me that some boxes have 25 raisins inside. Some boxes have 26 raisins inside. Some have 27. 28 and so on. Some boxes have even 31 raisins inside. And they made X's to show you how many boxes had that many raisins. So for example, just to help you understand the line plot, I can easily see that one box of raisins contained 25 raisins inside. Two of the boxes of raisins contained 26. Two of the boxes contained 27 raisins. Four of the boxes contained 28 raisins, and we could keep going from there. One box contained 30 raisins, and one box contained 31 raisins. So, just to help you understand, the X in this case stands for boxes. Okay, so this is one box of raisins, two boxes of raisins, you get the idea. Okay. So you're going to use this data to answer these questions. What is the least number of raisins in a box? Okay, so you have to look here at this number line. What is the least number of raisins that any of the boxes had inside of them? Okay, what is the greatest number of raisins in a box? Okay, so what's the greatest number of raisins that any of the boxes had inside? Which number of raisins occurs most often? So that's where you have to look here at these X's. So like, what would you say is the most common amount of raisins per box? Look at the line plot to help you figure it out. How many boxes contain 28 or more raisins? That's tricky. You need to pay attention. 28 or more. So you have to look. You want to look at the number of boxes that contain 28 or more than that. So 29, 30, and 31. Those are all more than 28. So including 28 and more than that. Okay. How many boxes contain fewer than 27 raisins? So less than 27. Okay. If we're looking for fewer than 27 and we're not including 27, then that would have to only be 26 and 25, because those numbers are both fewer than 27. Okay, so pay attention to the wording that they're using. Number 35, last question. How many boxes were used in the survey in all? Okay, remember the X stands for boxes. Okay, good luck. Remember to put your answers on the Google form when you're done.